I'd like to show you the perfect example of an always perfect uniform. White hat, clean white hat, apron, name tag, white shirt, white pants, runners, and a white belt, regulation pizza white belt. The following procedures are for the assistant manager or the counter person that's working along with the cook. The manager or the cook will arrive at the same time at 10 a.m. and he will first scrape and wash the insides of the ovens. Then he'll bring all the pizza making materials to make the pizza pockets and pizzas out to the front line here. At that point, he is also checking these off as he goes. He or she will make 12 pizza pockets altogether, 9 regular, 3 spicy, 6 pizza slices, 2 pepperonis, 2 supers, 1 vegetarian, 1 Hawaiian, and ensure that there are buns to make 12 sandwiches, as well as preparing at least 12 soups, and checking these items off as they go. Because there is a lot of baking and cooking of these items, that's suggested that the manager get to making the pizzas and the pockets by 10:15 at the very latest, so that all of these items are ready for 11 o'clock. That is the whole point of coming in at 10 o'clock, is to be sure that the store is ready to go by 11. Make sure at 11 too, we're both checking, the assistant manager and the manager is checking that the door is open and that we're ready to go by 11. And it's the manager's responsibility to ensure that the driver is here by 11. If the driver is even 1 minute late, look into it, phone him right away, because we can't operate without it. Okay, we're arriving at 10 a.m. First things first, we take down the chairs after we've turned on the lights. And although the chairs and tables were cleaned the night before, just to make sure they're perfect to start off with, we'll clean everyone this morning. Designed a checklist for this, so to make sure we get everything right, perhaps we should check it off as we go. We've turned on the lights, we've taken down the chairs and wiped the tables. Next, we'll be going to the front window. With the opening checklist, we've turned on all the lights, washed the front doors and windows at the entrance, washed all 3 washrooms, taken down the chairs, wiped the tables. We're going to clean and fill the napkin dispenser. Dispensers. As well, of course, as making sure they're full. We're checking to see that all brands are in stock and that we have each brand here and out on the counter. If any of them are running low, you might want to open another carton. We're going to check the cash float left from the previous night. The cash float will be made up of the bills and change in the till, as well as the change that is in the basket beside it. We'll check last night to realize that there should have been a $250 float left. We'll count the money, the $250, out and note any discrepancy. As well as that, we're going to check all of the counts from last night, right from boxes through slices, pot, lasagna, milk, juice, etc., to ensure that what the closing count last night will be the same as the opening count today. Also, just before we open the doors, we're going to ensure that all flavors of juices, pops, and milk are in the cooler, perhaps enough to serve all the customers we expect through the busy lunch rush. Once we've checked all the items for the assistant manager or the counter person when they come in, if it is 11 a.m., open the doors exactly at 11, and just before you open the doors, make a quick check to make sure that the store is ready for customers. I have the cleaning list in front of me. We have a daily cleaning duties that are separated into day-by-day items. It's starting with Monday morning shift, Monday evening shift, etc., etc. And today, being Saturday morning, we have on Saturday morning shift the pizza ovens, outsides of the pizza ovens, the shelves, the lower shelves in the kitchen, the shelves under the front counter, the front pop cooler, and the ledge under the stand-up counter. The ovens, which is a fairly long process, will be gotten into later. First things first, though, and we'll check these as we go, will be the lower shelves in the kitchen. Those in the kitchen are all the white shelves. And this cleaner, 10 parts water, 1 part cleaner, and a J-cloth will do it just right. If these are cleaned as per the schedule, they'll never get grungy, they'll never get bogged down, and a simple wipe will serve to clean them. I'm not going to clean all the shelves here, but this is the general idea. The shelves in the kitchen will include all the shelves on the lower parts where everything's being stored. It wouldn't even hurt to move some of the items to clean around instead of cleaning around. As I've completed that, I will check it off. And next, we're going to move to the shelves under the front counter. Shelves under the front counter will include everything here under the serving area, as well as the microwave oven. Again, if this is done as the schedule suggests, it'll never get too dirty or too bogged down. And it, I'll check that off as well. Net front pop cooler on the list. work has been done this morning. As you can see, it's very clean. It's best to do it first thing when they're before you've filled it up with pot. But even if you have it filled up with pot, you know, I would clean around it and clean the door, because this is an item that the customers can see easily. Saturday morning shift is the ledge under the stand-up counter. This is an item that is on the cleaning list for every afternoon. The ledge under the stand-up counter is this part here, the ceramic tile and the window ledge, which seems to get dirty, especially this time of the year, the winter. And I think it's very important to constantly clean it. That's why it's on the cleaning list every day. I've cleaned a section of it. The ledge under the front counter includes the ledge under the whole stand-up counter all the way around the store. And as I check that off, I've realized that I've taken care of all the duties for Saturday morning shift. That doesn't mean that we're not allowed to clean anything that is not on the schedule for that morning. But if everybody follows through on their parts, the store will be in perfect condition. Some pocket dough. What I need for that is the scraper, weigh scale set to zero, and this is the container the pocket dough will come in. Dough is empty from the bag. Cut into portions of 5 ounces. At this point, the dough is turned over till we can form a nice small ball and placed in the tray. The other pieces are also placed in the tray. Be careful so that they don't touch, so that they can be extracted from the tray easily. It's also very important, as soon as the dough is rolled, to... Okay, we're Saturday afternoon. We've received our commissary order about an hour ago, and most of the items have been put away as they're supposed to be. We'll notice that all the meats over here we have color-coded as to being the oldest first. Always the oldest first will be the easiest to grab, and we put the new stuff as we receive it at the back. Bacon, salami, Italian ham, hot sausage, ground beef. Down here we've prepared enough soup for our shift. We'll notice that each soup is dated as to when it was opened and decantered. The lasagna and spaghetti in these packages here will have the oldest out front and the newest at the back. Pepperoni, as the boxes come in, they're dated from, these are the sixth. The oldest on the left, and as we receive it, we put it in on the right. The sauce has been made up ahead of time. Its rotation isn't as important, but we should always use the sauce that's made up first. Mushrooms, rotation, very important. The new mushrooms we receive go to the back, the old mushrooms to the front. We've rolled the dough. Naturally, when we roll the dough and proof it outside, we're going to bring it in the cooler and put it at the bottom of the tray, of all the other trays, so that we use the oldest dough first. Since we have enough dough to last us, dough and cheese to last us through the weekend, this hasn't been prepped, but we know that if, for example, we've received cheese today and the cheese are in this pile, that we'll put the cheese we received at the bottom of the pile. Okay, as soon as the order comes in, we take it to the make line. We realize that it's not adding on to a different order or anything else, and it's a small, thick For a small thick, he's going to use a medium piece of dough. As you take the dough out, you're always careful you don't leave part of the dough in the tray. First step, of course, is to flour and stretch. The person who might be shipping this order is going to be checking already to realize that the pizza is supposed to be well done. Sometimes a good suggestion for a well done pizza is to mark it so that we're aware as it's being cooked that it has to stay in a little longer. We'll also notice that there's two Pepsis and an orange crush on that order that we're going to perhaps put in the bag and ready to go as the pizza's being cooked. Half a ladle of sauce spread out to within a quarter inch of the edge of the pizza. Put the ingredients on in the exact order that they're written down on the order. All the meats are refrigerated, especially this being a Saturday afternoon, we're not exceptionally busy. All the meats would be refrigerated and just brought out for the pizzas as they're ordered. As you can see, this is a pizza with many items on it. It's always a good idea to double check these because the customer is paying a premium price for a pizza with all these things on it, and we have to make sure that they get what they've ordered. Is finished and into the oven. I wanted to, you know, illustration of a pizza pocket. I'm going to make four pockets exactly the way we're supposed to make them. It's very important to follow each step as I'm doing it, because we want every single pizza pocket to come out of this store to look and taste the same. I'm removing the dough first. The dough is to be floured, flattened out a little bit, and put into the pocket stretcher with the adjustment at 4.5. This stretches it out to a circular size of 7 inches in diameter. We're going to make four at one time. two different types of pizza pockets. One is a spicy beef, and the other is what we call regular, pepperoni, mushroom, and cheese. The spicy beef has beef, hot peppers, and cheese. One ounce of cheese into the middle of the dough. Next, pizza sauce on top of the cheese. One ladle will go for four pizza pockets. For the regular pizza pockets, the next step are fresh mushrooms. And five pieces of pepperoni per pocket. For the spicy beef pocket, ground beef, hot peppers. In order to seal the pocket shut, we dab water around the outside of half of the pocket. The other half gets folded over so that none of the ingredients leak out. Now, in order to tell the difference, once they're enclosed, obviously we don't know what's inside them, but since I just made them, I know that that one's the spicy beef. I will put these four crimp marks in all the regular pockets. And now, just so they're pleasing to the eye, has nothing to do with the taste of them, I'm going to trim them so that we will think that a machine made these. The last step, just before they're put in the oven, we're going to glaze them with an egg glaze around the whole pocket. And now the pockets are ready for the onion to go into the oven for exactly 8 minutes at 450 degrees. I'd just like to emphasize that the only way that we're going to be able to tell the appearance, what kind they are the crimp marks in the regular pockets, no marks in the spicy beef pockets. All the implements after use. items like the glaze or any of the condiments for the sandwiches should be refrigerated constantly. And we wash the utensils after every. And I think the pockets are ready. It's been exactly 8 minutes. They should be taken out. These are 80% ready for consumption as the customer orders one. We will put it on a cooking paper and heat it in the main oven until it's golden brown, which will take a further 2 minutes. It's in the oven for the pocket, brown all over, ready to go. Place in a pizza pocket bag, ready to be served. This is going to be the demonstration of a sandwich. For this, we need tomatoes, rolls, the cheese, we have mozzarella or Swiss. The meat that's requested, this one's roast beef, mayonnaise, and mustard. First we take the bun, cut it in half. Mayonnaise on one side. Mustard on the other. Three tomatoes. Two pieces of mozzarella cheese. Salt and pepper. One packet of roast beef per sandwich. Cut in half. Always wrapped in a piece of wax paper. One paper per sandwich. Then we're finished. A sandwich, a corned beef sandwich this time. We have all the ingredients out, the tomatoes, buns, mozzarella cheese, we also have Swiss cheese if it's requested, regular mustard, we have Pomeranian mustard if it's requested, and mayonnaise. For corned beef, it's going to come in a package like this. Exactly half of this meat will go on one corned beef sandwich. So we will cut it like that, down the middle. Very important to put all open but unused meats in a separate plastic bag to ensure the freshness for the next sandwich. This portion will be used on the next sandwich. Cut the bun exactly in half. Mayonnaise on one side. A mustard on the other side. Three fresh tomatoes. Salt and pepper. This one is with mozzarella cheese. Two slices per sandwich. And the half a pouch of corned beef. Sliced exactly in half. Inside a piece of pizza. Wax paper. In the bag. And it's finished. Now, another important part of things is to refrigerate all the items. Unless, of course, there's another sandwich to be made immediately. We will refrigerate the buns. We're going to refrigerate the unused portions there. And provided there's no more sandwiches on board to make, we're going to wash the utensils right away. To make garlic bread, we use the knife for the cutting the bun, the spreader knife, garlic bread, and the buns. Again, we cut a bun exactly in half. We take the garlic butter, spread a generous portion on each half of the bun. Trying to cover all parts of the bread. At this point, we put some mozzarella cheese over the garlic butter. A very thin layer. It's 1 ounce for both sides, so a half an ounce each side. At this point, we take a piece of small cooking paper, place the bread on that, and put the bread. We'll take about 3 minutes and we'll pick it up again when it comes out. When it comes out, we'll cut the garlic bread, each slice into two, so it'll appear like there's four small pieces about this size. The garlic bread is ready now when the bun turns brown and the cheese is just melted. At this point, the bread is cut in half. Four half pieces then are put into the tray, sealed, and ready to go. Check the size. We're going to make sure that it reaches all corners of the paper, which it doesn't quite.
That's where it's going to come.
One ladle and a third of size. Spread out to a quarter of an inch from the end.
Yeast up here,
guys? Yes.
This is east.
West.
West?
It's west.
It's west.
And 65 pieces of pepperoni, so that each slice gets 10 to 11 pieces. I'm doing this by sight for the 65 pepperonis because I know what it looks like, but I wouldn't hesitate to count them out if I was having trouble with that. Rich is going to make a Hawaiian pizza slice now, which consists, of course, of cheese and sauce and ham and pineapple. It is sold as a special slice for $1.75, and the sales of Hawaiian slices have increased dramatically lately, so it might be a better idea to have a few more on hand and ready for the customer when they're set to order. Again, the check on the board to see if it's large enough. He's going to make sure that it covers all corners of the cooking paper, as it does appear large enough. Again, a ladle and a quarter of pizza sauce in the middle. Spread to a quarter inch from the edge of the crust. Putting 13 ounces of cheese on. Again, he's doing it by sight with the cheese. If there seems to be any problem in that area, obviously you're just going to have to weigh the first few until it becomes an automatic reaction. And it's ready for the oven. We're going to cook the Hawaiian slice about 80%, as we'll be heating up each individual slice for the customer. Beautiful. Also, I believe the well-done pizza is done now. While the pizza was being cooked, we got out the drinks for the order, 2 Pepsi and 1 orange. Small pizza cut into 6 slices. Ready to be shipped out. Next, please.
$11.98, please. Thank you.
Okay, 706 Girard Leader TV. I'd like 776, please.
At no time in the procedure did he ever touch the product with his hands.
Thank you.